This is what a regular React Native component looks like. We import React, create a function, and export it. But what happens when TypeScript joins the party? First of all, the extension of the file changes to .tx or .tsx, with the latter being for files with React components. What you should know is that TypeScript is all about setting the facts about your components and their properties straight. So if I have a function like this, TypeScript wants me to make it clear what exactly this function will return. Will it be a string, a component, or a number? Knowing that my function will return a component, which will make it a function component, I'll import the exact type from the source. And then after the name of the function, I'll assign the type to it using a colon. So if I mistakenly return something else, TypeScript will yell at me to correct it. For the properties to be received, we can define an interface or a type object for it. Either works fine. In the object will be a list of the expected properties and the appropriate types for them. Optional ones will have the question mark attached to their names. If we are expecting children, that will certainly be a React node and we'll get that type from React. Using angle brackets, we assign the type of our props to the function. Now if we use our component elsewhere, it will expect to receive all the required props and reject any additional one which is not defined. In the situation where you don't know the exact type to use, you can use the any type to save the day. You can even decide not to assign the types in the first place and use it only where you are comfortable. TypeScript is okay with that. I'll work on a future video with tips on how to identify the exact types to use, so stick around. We talked about how to set up React Native projects with TypeScript in this video and how to add TypeScript to existing React Native projects in this other video, so you can check them out.